Hi friends, today we are going to learn about how to design a asynchronous counter. For learning this topic, we will learn with an example. So now we are going to learn about mod 6 asynchronous counter. So here also same formula we will use. 2 power n is greater than or equals to capital N, then 2 power n is greater than or equals to 6, then for n equals to 3, this case will be satisfied. So 3 number of inputs and 3 number of flip-flops are required in the here. So the 3 number of inputs are A, B and C and clock pulse. We will take clock pulse and the output is Y. So 3 variable means we will get up to 7. 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0 and 1, 1, 1. These are the inputs of A, B, C. And clock pulse, 0 first row. When 0 clock pulse is given, no change in the input. 1 clock pulse, 2 clock pulse, 3 clock pulse, 4 clock pulse, 5 clock pulse, 6 clock pulse and 7th clock pulse. So as we are discussing about mod 6 asynchronous counter, before 6 all the outputs are 1. And after at 6 and after 6 the outputs are 0. So these are called as valid states and these are called as invalid states. This is the table. Now we have to draw the K map and logic diagram, and the K map is for the output Y, A, B, C, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0 and 0, 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7, we are not having anything. So this forms the two quads, that is Y is equals to A bar plus B bar. This is one quad and this is one quad. So Y equals to A bar plus B bar. Now we have to draw the logic diagram. As we require 3 number of flip-flops, 3 flip-flops are taken. That is TA, any flip-flop can be taken. I am taking T flip-flop. TA, TB, TC, A bar input, B bar, C and C bar. As this is a asynchronous counter, the output of one flip-flop is the input of other flip-flop. Here is the clock pulse. So all we are getting 1 as output, so for TA, for TB and for TC, all outputs are 1. And the output Y we are getting as A bar plus B bar. A bar plus B bar, this is the output Y. And here we are going to use one clear, that is CLR, clear. CLR. These are connected to each other. And the output is connected to the clear of the last one. This is the process of doing an asynchronous counter. And asynchronous counter is also called as ripple counter. This is the process of designing the asynchronous counter or ripple counter. If you are having any doubts regarding this topic or any other topic, please do contact us or comment us on Instagram. That is honey_veena. Please do like and subscribe our channel. Thank you for watching.